Welcome! In this video, I'll be showing how the FIO UX 380N is in general use. I'll be running some applications and games on it, and we'll show how it performs and does modern things in 2020. First, we'll start by logging in using the built-in fingerprint scanner. This was a handy feature that allowed you to log into the system by swiping your finger down. It will then start to load the Windows operating system. Now that the unit has started up, we'll be showing the FIO launcher as first. This is one of the applications included and is aimed to make using the FIO UX more easy, given it has a very tiny screen. This launcher offers you quick access to internet, email, music, pictures, the camera, and some settings. We'll be starting by doing some web browsing, a common task to be done on a computer like this. The FIO UX originally shipped with Internet Explorer 7. As this browser is completely useless today, I've upgraded it to Internet Explorer 9 and installed MyPal, which is a browser still being made for Windows XP and Windows Vista computers. Any of the other browsers are simply so obsolete that you cannot use them anymore to browse the web. If you use Internet Explorer, you'll see that a lot of pages will not load properly. If we go to, a popular website such as CNN, we will see that this browser is not able to display it properly. It's very slow, and if it even loads, it will show everything messed up. Using the more modern browser, MyPal, is also very slow. It's a large browser and it takes a while to start up, and most pages will take a while to load. So as for web browsing, this would have been very useful back in the day, but for now in 2020, this simply isn't possible anymore on this type of computers. Loading the CNN website took forever. Next, we'll be doing some media playback. Windows Vista, of course, includes the Windows Media Player, which can play music, show pictures, and play videos. Well, if it actually wants to play it. Okay, so here it goes. It's at least showing the visualizations and the album art. Playing a video works just fine. You might have noticed that the screen on this device is really small. If you open some of the built-in applications, the texts and the elements are just tiny. Therefore, Sony has added the zoom buttons on the right. If you press these, the screen will zoom in so you can read things more easily. It has to be said, though, that the zoom feature is not really that great, as it's very laggy, and once zoomed in, the screen just feels not very responsive at all, especially at 1.5 times zoomed in. At 2 times, it's actually a lot more responsive to work with. And it also disables the transparency of the Windows Vista theme. So if we zoom back out, it will restore back to normal. One of the more gimmicky features, I have to say, is the camera software. It includes a built-in camera capture software, and it even includes a camera capture button. The cameras were of decent quality back in the day, so that's why Sony probably decided to include a capture utility to take photos and videos with the cameras. However,
Its practical use remains to be seen. Who thought anybody would need this?
Probably just wanted to put some gimmicks on this device. Okay, I have to say it sounds cool, but other than that, I guess nobody would ever be pressing that button once more. The next part will be about productivity applications, such as Microsoft Office and reading documents. This was one of the main use cases for the VGN UX series computers, as it was intended for business users who need to read or write documents while on the go. As we can see, the device has Office 2007 installed. By showing Word, we can see that it shows pages correctly. You can add images, you can add titles, you can type. But I have concluded that typing on this keyboard isn't really pretty. You almost can't feel the keys. And there's a lot of times when you make errors or type the wrong keys. Also, it seems to have the tendency to click the mouse for some reason while typing, and I'm not sure if that's my fault or that some of the keys are actually broken on this unit. Look, it's clicking while I see it. I'm pressing here the menu button, which is located just beside the spacebar. How inconvenient. And that's the Windows key. So I've almost hit everything but the right letters. Alright, with two hands I finally managed to make one sentence on this unit.
My impressions with PowerPoint and Excel were basically the same as with Word. These applications are mainly useful to read presentations and spreadsheets, not to create them. The device is simply too tiny in order to type a lot on it.
Finally, I'll be opening a PDF document. It greatly showcases some of the capabilities. Because for reading documents, this is actually quite nice. It displays them correctly. You can scroll with either the arrow keys or the mouse. And you can here use the zoom buttons really nicely to better read the documents. So yeah, that's it for productivity. Unfortunately, I cannot show email because this version of Outlook is so old that Gmail throws all kinds of security warnings showing that this email client is not secure and it should not be using my Gmail account. We just saw that for productivity, the device was mainly useful to read content, not to write it. However, you can connect this unit to the dock, also known as port replicator, in order to connect it to an external monitor, keyboard and mouse. That way, you can use it as a full-fledged desktop computer and start writing documents, creating spreadsheets or making your presentations. Putting the unit in the dock is as easy as just sliding it in, and then it will automatically switch the display and connect to all USB devices plugged into the dock, as well as the optional Ethernet connection, which I'm not currently using. It takes a while though, but eventually the monitor will turn on and we have a nice large display on which we can do some real work. We can use the mouse and then we can just start writing like a pro. When you're done with your work, you can simply slide it out of the dock and it will become a mobile device once again. All USB devices will disconnect and it will start using the built-in mouse and keyboard again. Finally, I'd like to talk a bit about games. This unit was never really made to play any games, so it is only an integrated graphics card and, well, forget about playing any modern games on it, it simply will not do it. However, some of the very old and light games will actually work. Once the game is finally loaded, we can see that it plays Roller Coaster Tycoon. Whether this is really enjoyable is up to you. I mean, you have to like the game, which I do, but the controls aren't really the greatest, with the mouse moving very slowly and it's pretty hard to get it precisely where you want. But if you do, it can be fun. It can be fun and it's a cool way to play a retro game.
If you're more into gaming, I highly recommend connecting the unit to the dock, as this gives you the ability to use the keyboard and mouse, as well as to connect a USB CD DVD drive. This allows you to play a lot more games, as most PC games that are working on this device actually require a CD or DVD to be present in the drive. Now, we can play the original Roller Coaster Tycoon, not just the open source remake of it.
You'll notice that you cannot connect external speakers to the dock. It will still play the audio through the internal speakers of this device. However, there's a cutout here in the dock, so you can connect your own headphones or speakers while it's still in the dock.
Playing games with an external keyboard and mouse definitely works a lot better than with the built-in mousepad and keyboard. This makes it actually fun to play some retro games. Now, let's try another game, which is a lot more basic than Roller Coaster Tycoon. We'll be playing DX Ball, which is a variant of the popular game Breakout. This is a very old game, but it still works perfectly fine on Windows Vista.
Playing some more simple games is no problem for this device, it will do it just fine.
Wrapping it up for games, you cannot play any modern games, however some very simple games and some remakes of older games and open source variants are playable.
Alright guys, this wraps up my video about the Sony Vaio VGN UX380N. I've shown you quite some usages of it and I hope you liked watching my video. Please like, comment and subscribe to my YouTube channel, because there's probably still more to come. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comments, And don't forget to check out my website about the FIO Fijian UX380M, as it offers you drivers, free service for recovery disk, and some information about running various apps on, and games on it. Bye!